We go back to our top story. Congressman Benjo Benaldo found at the House of Representatives with a gunshot wound. Let's now talk to House Speaker Sonny Belmonte. Good evening, Speaker Belmonte.
Good evening.
This is Speaker Sonny Belmonte. Yeah, this is Tina Palma, Tina, sir. Kamusta po kayo?
Tina, how are you?
I'm good. What can you tell us, sir? What do you know so far?
Well, all right. Sometime after 7 o'clock, Congressman Benjo Benaldo ng Cagayan de Oro.
It looks like we have a better signal. Speaker Belmonte, you're back on the world tonight. So what additional details do you have as soon as it was discovered that there was a gunshot wound?
Okay. These his people and others there rushed him to the New Era Hospital, which was they wouldn't bring him to a further hospital because of traffic.
Yes.
Now, I arrived in the hospital. As soon as I got word about it, I left for the New Era Hospital, and after a while, I was admitted in, and I saw him. For one thing, he was conscious. He was very conscious, in fact. And you could converse with him. And Congressman Miro Kimbo, who is his good friend, and myself were there, and we were trying to buoy up his spirits. And he was laughing with us and so forth. Sabi namin, kaya mito. And later on, his Brazilian wife or partner came in also, and they chat. I saw her give him a hug. And then I authorized that she be transferred to another hospital.
Okay, would you know, Speaker Belmonte, if the doctors had treated him for the wounds that he has?
I could see that there was some bleeding, because I saw a bottle with used blood, so alam ko merong bleeding. And obviously they did something to stop the bleeding and to bandage him up. And so forth. And they also, I could also see that there was a IV into his arm. But outside of that, he also had an oxygen mask. But outside of that, he was okay.
Oh, saan po nilagyan yung bandage? At what part of his body, sir?
Well, alam mo, he was under a blanket, no? So I didn't look myself, but I asked the doctor exactly where was the wound, and he said that the wound is somewhat below the heart, and that the trajectory is downward, so that possibly some parts of his lungs were hindi lang possibly, they are sure that some parts of his lungs were injured. And also that the bullet exited from his back.
The bullet exited from?
It towards his back. More to the side, to the back, and on so on. But it exited.
Opo. So have you talked to the scene of the crime operatives, po, from the Batasan police or from the security of the house?
Well, the Secretary General gave the Sergeant at Arms, General Rodovan, a former chief of police of Quezon City, orders not to have the room locked up and so forth. Ako naman, I called him up also and told him that to open it up and allow normal police procedures to be done. And I was right beside Colonel Richard Albano, the director of the Quezon City Police Department at the time. So they talked to each other, and then I said, no, let the police investigation proceed.
Opo. Yeah. Would you know sino ho ang kasama niya sa kwarto when this happened? Meron ho siyang kasama, security
and
stuff?
He was alone in his room, and there were I think 3 employees, including a driver and an assistant and another person in the outer room. in the outer room. So yung inner room, he was alone there. And in the outer room were these three people who heard the shot and who brought him down.
Okay.
Brought him out of the... His office appears to be in the fifth floor of the south wing.
Okay, so kinarga po siya from his office to the south lawn or the south lobby onto a vehicle to go to the New Era Hospital? Ganun po ba yun?
I think that is the logically happened because that's also the way it is described by some people.
Opo. So, kinwento ba sa inyo kung paano siya nakita? Nasa loob siya ng kwarto? Was he seated? Was he standing up? Was he on the floor?
No, he was sitting down on his desk, on his chair.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, ano
ho ang... He was sitting down on his chair and apparently, hindi naman unconscious. According to the to one of those who went in, the gun was on the table.
On the table. So he was not holding it when they got to him.
Yeah.